Banjo Palo. PS2 probably. I would guess.
I like the pick of going to Palutena. I mean, this is Hydra's tried and true. Definitely like won him most of the sets today. And Banjo showed to be really, really, really confident in the Wolf matchup. But I would say, like, being a Palutena main himself, Ray would know very well of like what Palutena is looking for. It also gives him an edge.
Yeah, no shortage of matchup experience and matchup familiarity, having played the characters himself and played a couple of the New York Palus that are prevalent, some by the name of Jen and like others. But it'll be interesting how he'll use the tools of Banjo to circumvent options that like are relatively linear. Palutena's most glaring flaw in a lot of cases is her linearity as a character. So that linear, even if you know what she's gonna do, like Ray is so intimate with that knowledge, like that the play, she's still a top 10 character for a reason, because that play strings are just so good. So it'll be interesting to see how he circumvents those with Banjo's toolkit as he's making regular use of this Wonder Wing.
I really like how patient Ray is being with his landings. He's waiting for just the right moment for Hydra to whiff his up air, so that he can try to drift around and then land back safely, using basically the most out of all of his stalls, his up B, his grenade movement, and of course, his plethora of jumps.
Yeah, he's getting a little bit too antsy trying to apply that corner pressure, throwing out back air just too close.
I love that commitment, but it's actually not going to be able to take the stuff quite yet. Hydra very, very smart to hold onto his jump, going to get the platform extended neutral air combo, because Ray was set up for the tech chase on the platform and ended preemptively there. 40% though, nothing to sneeze at.
Yeah, but you have to always accept that 40% comes out as a couple of an egg extension, but a good roll away and not to worry about.
Did you see that wave from Hydra? He was like, I'm gonna pummel until that grenade comes back, explodes in your face, and then I'm gonna throw you. Just like optimized his damage output super good, got the read on the tech in, but unfortunately let it rip a little bit too early.
Okay, going for the fair, trying to read the air dodge out, but instead crosses him up with it. And we see a lot of this game being played on the neutral getup situation. Hydra finding himself frequently holding shield against the ledge as Ray is just throwing out a lot of back airs and a lot of F-tilts to keep him there. As he extended his hand into the Wonder Wing. Wonder Wing hit ledge.
Already 14%, but more importantly, saves himself from just landing that one multi-jab, catching the attack there with a very nicely timed counter. I don't think he tried to counter. I think he might have wanted to deflect the projectile, but I don't know.
That was a dare out of shield too. An awkward option for sure. One not expect.
I like the fact that Ray respected the explosive flame, like knowing, okay, you know what, I better not try to overextend at this moment. I still have the lead. I'm just gonna let him get away with it.
Yeah.
Just neutral getting right into the fully charged down smash. Ray trying to end it all with that really, really aggressive 1D wing, but not gonna find it.
And he uses the platforms to get back pretty much unscathed, not having to worry about any ledge pressure or two-frame opportunity. Mm-hmm. I mean, Hydra has been giving up the neutral getup so many times, I'm not surprised that down smash was scouted out.
That was so good! Ray perfectly solved himself and was able to jump above the explosive flame and still be able to hit Hydra, who trying to juggle him using his own projectiles. Ray's knowledge of Palutena and his spacing is just fantastic.
Yeah, bites him back here. Frequently, we see him in those corner situations rise with that back air and use the multi-hit to cover a lot of space, and like that entire area was locked off, and for preventing Hydra from like jumping forward and jumping in aggressively, which is what made finding a lot of damage and a lot of kills in those situations a lot harder than they needed to be or expected to be for someone like Palutena.
Why does game Banjo look like that?
Why does Banjo look like that? He's a bear.
It's kind of ugly.
Rude.
Yeah, rude.
Yeah, you know, I'm fine with saying it. I think Banjo's kind of ugly. Why does he look like that? Why does he look like that?
He's a bear. He's I like him. He's cartoony.
How would you feel if someone said that to you?
Yeah, okay, I'm sorry, Banjo. Too bad. Kazooie? Kazooie? Mm.
Kazooie is a queen.
Kazooie is a queen.
Kazooie's mean. Kazooie's queen energy. She's rough.
Hydra giving us the between game interviews. I'm losing to a character I don't even own. Just get him.
Yeah, just buy the character. Yeah, man.
$5.99 will buy you a character.
Is he $6 or is he $5?
I think it's $6 because he had a stage.
Yeah, it's $5.99.
Okay. Alright. Hydra, go on Twitter.com and ask for $6. And you should be good.
There you go. Easy clap. Yeah. Ready?
He's not sure, really, man.
He's unsure if he's ready.
It was just like, ready? He's just like with Roy. And he's like, now I'm going to go back.
Roy? I don't know if he's really our boy.
Is Roy our boy? The answer's no.
I'm very happy that we actually have Yoshi Story music. This to me is nostalgic. I'm very happy about this.
Yoshi Story is OD. I don't understand why this stage is like disputed. I like this stage.
It's fantastic. I agree. For sure.
It's goated.
Ray trying to catch a couple of jumps off from the platform there, getting a little bit of good damage. And I think Ray was also hit by his own grenade. The ultimate betrayal.
Neutra got up, standing grabbed. Like, I love that, because he's holding shield at ledge. He's looking for a grab. It's like, no, I got you first. Haha.
That's an interesting choice, though, to go for your standing grab at that position. I think his intention behind it was Ray is going to try to do a drop-down jump grenade, and he might be able to grab through that.
I mean, you're right. That is a frequent option that Banjo does. But in a standing grab situation, why wouldn't you do something with Roy that would net you a little bit, like of a better angle, something like a down tilt, because he's jumping up from ledge.
He doesn't want to hit it and eat the explosion. He's thinking he could grab him and get the throw on him and shoot it.
Right, fair.
And then he's going to get the re-grab into the belly, into the up tilt. Very, very nice from Ray. 120% for going to be hit with the final hit of Roy's side beat.
Yeah, double-edged dance, killing a ridiculously early percent. Just being so strong and really, really quick. As the air dodge up is what provides a little bit of an extra hype boost in order to provide a mix-up.
That early uppy was so important, otherwise he would have lost the stuff right there, which would have been so unfortunate considering he's only at 39%. It was, you know, it was like a last-ditch effort, and it definitely worked out for him in the end.
Yeah, he's making sure to utilize these platforms really well, but at the same time, he's kind of using his double jump really early once he gets on them. A lot of these grenades giving out a lot of damage. It's the raw taunt in between the fluster coming through.
Something I've noticed is how Hydra, after hitting his up tilt, backed off completely thinking Ray was going to continue holding forward. He seems very unfamiliar with trying to punish Ray up being out of disadvantage. I don't even think Roy inherently is able to cover that kind of space without overcommitting.
Roy over, naturally, I guess, kind of overcommits because he's so fast and his sword is, wants to be close to you to get its
that
sweet spot.
That grenade coverage. I'm so sorry to interrupt you, but
you're fine.
The only reason that Wonder Wing was safe is because Ray grabbed that grenade midair and it exploded them both and reset neutral. That was, that was a chef kiss. That was brilliantly played.
Yeah, it functions a lot like Snake's grenade in that instance, but you're throwing this grenade a lot more. He won't lose.
He just sat there and taunted like something. Yeah, no, he's not gonna hold forward.
And down throw. Yeah. Okay, that's fine.
Goes right through the backfield, doesn't even want to start the barely mix up. Just thinking, yeah.
Oh, the up smash is confirmed at that percent. Up smash is confirmed starting at 150.
Interesting. But honestly, why not just opt for the less execution heavy option?
This is true. I mean, either one kills, so.
Ooh, throwing that up tilt already 3 times in a row, but that's going to be the up tilt, actually, this time. To take out the stock, this is effectively even 19 and 0%, respectively.
This is real Wi-Fi, Alex. He's just raw taunting. But, Ray is unfazed with how much like damage and how much options he's covering at once, using the eggs to catch the like do nothing quote unquote option, while the grenade covers in front or behind, and Banjo himself is lingering just close enough to wait for the option that you pick and be there with his nair or with his back air when that time comes.
That retreating grenade was super, super good because it covered the tech roll in, and it would give Ray the opportunity to grab the grenade and throw it if Hydra teched in place or teched out. So I really like that option there. But once again, using the grenade to reset neutral after Wonder Winging onto Hydra's shield, I really, really like that. It's very, very smart, very safe. Getting the jail, not gonna kill quite yet. Respecting the up B landing, trying to get a standing grab, not quite yet.
He saved his second jump, that was super nice. And these down tilts are super great at catching the two frame down. Up tilt. Oh, he went for the up smash that time as the other side of the mix up, but a good mash.
Fastest smash. He was out of there frame one. And ended up buffering an up B as well.
You can buffer the mash. Like once you start mashing during the throw, it counts for you like being buried, so you can get out of that super quick. Yeah. 142 though is he lands with the Pharaoh and the shield, but raw back air is going to send Banjo back into an offside situation.
That's a double jump.
He won't lose.
Once again, using the grenade to Wonder Wing right onto his shield. This is anybody's game. That's going to be the back throw. Not going to kill quite yet because he's across the stage. Impeccable the eye. This is still anybody's game. If Ray is able to get the successful ledge trap, and he is, that tilt spaced so perfectly. And that means UtopianRay is going to be the XeNOwifi 3 champion.
Great stuff from UtopianRay, spacing out a lot of his tilt super safely, playing around Roy's effective range and effective dash in space really nicely, always having grenade on hand, and able to stay safe and stay mobile even when he was putting a lot of inlines in stuff like Wonder Wing or in stuff like his Banjo's Fair. As he dips immediately, let's be sure to check Twitch chat for the Ray experience.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think Ray played that super, super well. He did a fantastic job. Hydra also played that really well, almost making the comeback game 2, despite having a deficit. But anyways,